World War II.
One of the worst wars in modern history. It officially began in 1939 when Germany invaded Poland.
They were trained and they were well trained.
The invasion led Britain and France to declare war, and the battles began. But as war raged in Europe, the U.S. remained silent.
At the beginning, we didn't want anything to honestly do with it.
But then came the attack on Pearl Harbor.
December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy.
It made me so angry that I drew a picture of a Japanese and put it on a cottonwood tree in the cattle yard, and I filled it full of holes.
And with much of the country feeling that way too, the U.S. geared up for war, and American soldiers started to see what war-torn Europe was really like.
Everything was topsy-turvy. Everything was tore up.
The fighting came to a head in 1944. The Allied forces had been planning an attack in France, an attack they geared up for in the town of Portsmouth.
Portsmouth in the UK is a calm seaside town. Calm breeze, calm waves. That was the case 75 years ago, too, as soldiers geared up for D-Day. But Portsmouth was the calm right before the storm.
How young the people they were. 18, 19 year olds.
By the end of the battle, over 5,000 Allied troops lost their lives, but all five beaches were secured, which meant victory.
The Allies then went on and defeated the Germans, which was, you know, a big thing. And it also freed my father after being in a POW camp for 6 years.
And after the Battle of the Bulge in Europe and the atomic bombs in Japan, it meant the war was finally over. Although one World War II veteran says we should put that victory and that time in history into perspective.
We were not the greatest generation. We were just a generation that was called on to provide for the future and to take care of an enemy that was going to conquer us. And we did it.
A generation that fought for a cause they believed in and ensured liberation and freedom for many in the process.